Salif Keita's name is synonymous with the Malian royal family and griots, ancestral oral poet priests. Keita's childhood has been the subject of a BBC documentary and is truly the stuff of legend. As the saga of an African anti-hero, Keita's story could scarcely be bettered. Salif was born albino in a land where that skin is a sin. The great slabs of stone on which albinos would be sacrificed alongside other troublemakers still stand just outside his village. His father, Sina, was so shocked at his birth that he banned both infant and mother from the house. But goodness prevailed, and the father's faith was confirmed by the prediction of the village imam, the spiritual leader, that his son, Salif Keita, would achieve fame. Salif himself is noble, a direct descendant of the legendary warrior king Sundiata Keita, who founded the Mandinka Empire in 1240. The road to his dream was hard. While attending teacher's training school, the singer's weak eyes prevented him from obtaining his qualifications. When he turned to music as his refuge, his parents ordered him to leave the house, forcing the teenage Salif to sleep rough in the marketplace of Mali's capital, Bamako, to fulfill his dreams. Those days, of course, are long gone. The horror that his parents felt at the disgrace to their caste mellowed considerably as their misfit son became recognized as a national hero. Fame came swiftly. Salif soon became the singer of the rail band, then joined Les Ambassadeurs, taking with him the brilliant guitarist Kante Manfila. Both of these groups are legendary, and their early recordings are prized as highly as, say, those of Bob Marley and the Wailers before they signed an international deal. Synthesizing their African and Cuban influences with an awareness of French pop, they were responsible for forging a new national pop in a newly independent country. Intent on becoming an international artist, Keita has spent the last decade based in Paris, touring extensively in America and Europe. Thank you for joining CACE International. I'm Fikisha Cumbo, and we're sitting here in Island Records, Mango Records, talking to the wonderful Salif Keita of Mali. Welcome to New York City, Salif Keita.
Thank you.
Tell me of your trip to Africa and how the music you heard there influences your music.
The tour in Africa, South Africa, was great for me. It was really something new for me. It meant that I lost something, a part of my culture, because South Africa music is very good music and it's very close to my music, African music. So that was very, very great for me, for my music. The groove and the melody, I learned a lot of things about
Mbakwenga, it's called, the South African.
It's Bakwenga.
Bakwenga.
Bakwenga. And Xhosa. Yeah, and Xhosa and Zulu music. All of them. And of them. Very, very good country and nice people. Good music.
You use Nigerian high life and zouk and Afrobeat. What other musics do you put into the music of Salif Keita?
I think Zulu, Afrobeat, Zouk, and Highlife, all of them, they are African music, and I come from Africa. So I use all group I know I want to use. And I think Zouk is more West African music. Because you can do, if you want to do West African music straight and traditionally, you have to make zouk.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And highlife, yes, true, because I heard about highlife since I was young. 1969, 66, you know, around this time. And I like too much to feel around some good music.
Yes, yes.
Nigerian music, I love it. And so I met a lot of culture. And, that's why, for me, I come from Mali, but all of them, the group, African group, they are my group.
What instruments do you play?
I play a little guitar. And I know what about percussion, and I sing.
Do you play when you perform the guitar?
Yeah, it's a couple songs, one or two songs, acoustically.
Tell me, how did you come to music, to be in the career of music?
Because when I was young, I was supposed to be a teacher, and I couldn't do it because my eyes was not nice, you know. But, so suddenly, I don't had nothing to do. But my only aspiration was to be a gangster or to be a musician. But for me, it's more noble to be a musician more than a gangster, you know. So that's why I prefer that's to be a musician. I come to be a musician.
But your parents did not want you to.
Yes, true. But, you know, my parents, their time with the past, you know. I have to do my best. You know, it's just... I agree with them, and I love them, but how can do?
Yeah. How does reggae come into you?
Reggae is African groove. I'm sorry, it's African. It's really African, really. It's 150% is reggae. Reggae is African music. It's natural.
Thank you.